everybody, it's Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com, and today I'm putting the strawberry beds to bed. It's beginning of October. Usually by this time the beds look pretty done. Everything would be brown and everything would be just finished for the year. But because of all the rain we've had, we have a lot of growth that is really continuing on. We even have some strawberries over there from our everbearing. And I've gone through this area and half of this area, and what I'm doing is I'm taking out the weeds. I'm planting the little runners, thank you, that have grown out of the bed. If they have roots, I'm moving them into spaces that are not occupied by established plants. Some of them are very close together, but then we know that, you know, not all of them will make it. I had to save this because we often talk about the symmetry of Mother Nature and the Fibonacci patterns, meaning the repeated patterns of different plants. This obviously is a dandelion. It's not going to stay, but it was so huge and so pretty, I thought, well, at least we can get a picture of it.
It is amazing.
Before I take it out. The soil is perfect. We've had rain. It's not totally soaked, but it is easy to pull things, which is another great thing about this time of year if you've had some rain. Even from this side, it's pretty.
Yeah, you could cook it tonight and put it in our salad.
I could, but I don't want to.
Okay. Well, that's amazing. I mean, this is what, your third time?
Yes, at least my third time.
Working this
coming
bed?
Coming in here.
It's amazing.
Since the strawberries have been pretty much done producing, I've been in here three times pulling weeds. And that's okay. My biggest weed in here is the wood sorrel. And if you don't know what wood sorrel is, it has a clover leaf, three clover leaf, and I've saved one. And it has the little yellow flowers on it. And they are edible, if you want to try them. They have kind of a lemony taste. Would probably be good in a salad also, if you didn't eat too many. But there are thousands of seeds on just one plant. Let me show you a plant I pulled up. This is wood sorrel. You see the clover leaf on it. You see the yellow flowers. But look at these. These are the seed pods. And inside each seed pod is multiple seeds, tiny little seeds. And so once they plant themselves, look at that, just that one plant. How many seed pods are on just that one?
I mean, they're all over. You're
yes.
Standing in wood sorrel.
Yes, I'm standing in wood sorrel. This is also your your sweet woodruff and myrtle and cypress vine.
My goodness, look at that.
That thing better not come back.
Gee.
All I have to say. Pretty as it is, I don't want it back. And then we also, somewhere along the line, we picked up some violets. I remember our son saying, I hate those violets, and I'm thinking, how could you hate violets? Well, now I know, because they just spread and they take up a lot of space.
You're talking about the wild ones, right?
Talking about wild violets, yes.
Well,
yes.
Not only that, but when I saw this, I just about gasped.
Kind of scary, isn't it?
Look at this thing. I mean, this thing has popped up overnight almost with the rain.
This is good soil in here. We've amended this soil multiple times. We've kept it watered. And so, of course, a weed is going to be really happy to grow here.
Mm. I mean, that is scary.
Go.
That has to be, what, 4 foot?
Well, I'm 5'9".
4 foot tall. Yeah, that's amazing.
Let me get rid of it. Look what's in here. Look what's blooming. Looks what's being enjoyed by many. But if we had not had all of the rain that we've had, these would be long done.
That is amazing.
I'm going to get these. There's some more right there next to your feet. And there's probably more in here, but you can see all the wood sorrel. Everywhere, everywhere, everywhere.
It is prolific.
This is what I've been doing. I did it all through that bed and half of this bed. So what I do first is I look at my pathway. And sure enough, look at these beautiful strawberries growing here. Now they came out of here. And you can see there are empty spaces here. And see that nice root on there? So if they have really nice roots, I'm just transplanting them back into the bed.
Now, I know we had a couple of our visitors ask why you have these white hoops.
Mm-hmm. Well, there is a big maple tree right there. And there are maple trees across the street. And there are some springs when they are just millions of maple seeds that are falling down. One year, I remember, I had to pull out at least a million little trees.
Did you count them?
I did. So on years like that, when we think it's going to be horrible, we can put a row cover over these hoops. And that will not block the sun or the rain, but it'll keep the seeds out of here. So I don't have to pull up all the trees, because if you don't pull them up the first year when they're just tiny, the next year they are established and they are ready to grow into a maple tree.
I remember.
This is my basket with strawberries that have been in the pathways. Those are from those pathways, and I've filled in holes over here. So as I'm going down this way, I will be filling in more holes with the strawberries that I'm digging out. Even though it's October, we still have plenty of insects crawling around and flying around. There's mosquitoes over here next to this peony bed. There's been gnats. And I think I had Daddy Longlegs crawling in my hair for a minute, but I kind of knocked him out and he crawled away. So that's good. I'm almost done. The beds are looking really, really healthy. And I think I may have to sprinkle them a little bit for all the new plants that I've planted. But then I'm done, and looking forward to next spring when all of the strawberries have awoken from their little winter nap and rejuvenated themselves, and my mouth is ready already. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. And if you have comments or questions, we'd love to hear from you. Thank you so much for following us on YouTube and for being part of our garden family. And if you'd like to become part of our garden family, there's that little orangey red button over here someplace. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.
Connect with us on YouTube.